Today I'm going to talk to you about the top 10 part 2 careers that you can get with a bachelor's degree in environmental science or any of the majors that fall under the realm of an environmental science or environmental related degree. So I've already done a video on this and I'm gonna link to that above. That's top 12 careers you can get with an environmental degree. So this is part 2 of even more environmental jobs you can get with an environmental degree. If you want to learn more about environmental jobs, what it's like being a wildlife biologist, subscribe to my channel below. 60% of you who are watching this have not yet subscribed, so click that button below. A little bit of a disclaimer, these jobs are focused on a North American audience, so salary ranges are focused a little bit more on what North Americans would do. However, if you are international, it's also very relevant. Just take salary ranges with a grain of salt because it's going to totally depend on your country. Water quality scientist. So water quality scientists test and analyze water and often compare it to the standards that are set out in federal or state or local legislation. So this job generally involves sampling groundwater, surface water, and drinking water. So you can work for a variety of different companies and governments for doing this type of water quality science job. So often that includes public health organizations, governments, utility companies, energy companies. The average salary, according to eco.ca, for a water quality scientist is starting at around $55,000. Air quality scientists. So air quality scientists ensure that the air is clean and unpolluted in accordance to federal and local laws and legislation. So they identify the source of pollutants and make recommendations to improve air quality. They also will often review environmental assessment reports for like proposed factories or manufacturing plants in order to ensure that there's not an adverse effect of this new development on air quality. So the average salary for air quality scientists, according to PayScale, is around $53,000. Botanists. So botanists, very generally speaking, study plants. And they study how plants relate to their communities and their habitats. They might work for conservation of an endangered plant species. They might work for the preservation of redwood forests. There could be a really big variety of jobs within the botany sphere. Many can also work closely with the agricultural industry to conduct experiments on plant diseases, pests, or even using plants as medicine. They will work in labs, offices, out in the field, a big variety of different work environments. So the average salary, according to the U.S. Bureau of Labor, for a botanist is around $58,000. Agronomist. So similar to a botanist, but an agronomist really focuses on crop production specifically. Agronomists review the work that soil scientists and botanists do. They communicate this information to a wider public audience, such as farmers. They use the research that they learn from the scientists to actually implement real-world techniques on how farmers can improve their yield or reduce pests. They may consult specifically with farmers, for example, going out to a canola field and telling a farmer why a crop might be failing or maybe why soil is depleted of nutrients. So there's many different job opportunities within the sphere, especially if you live in an agricultural rural area where there's a lot of farming. So the average salary, according to environmentalscience.org, for an agronomist is around $58,000. Ecotourism operator. So an ecotourism operator generally involves anything within the realm of environmentally sustainable tourism. So that can include leading clients out on tours of the natural environment and explaining how to be more sustainable in their everyday life, running an eco lodge out in the Amazon rainforest, for example, a whale watching tours. This type of job really focuses on socially responsible travel and wildlife conservation and environmental sustainability. So the average salary for ecotourism operators starts at around $20,000 and it can rise up to around $68,000 with many years of experience. Fisheries scientist. So a fisheries scientist specifically studies fish populations and uses this information to contribute their knowledge to disease control, improvement of fish habitat quality and fish stock, and conservation. A fisheries scientist writes and implements projects that will specifically study fish. bringing in the research of the water quality, oxygen, diseases, food systems, all that impact the health of fisheries. So they may work in the field or at an environmental consulting firm or for an energy or mining company specifically with government or even at a private fish hatchery. The average salary for fishery scientists starts at around $35,000 with a bachelor's degree and rises up to around $60,000 to $80,000 as you gain years and years of experience. GIS specialist. So GIS stands for Geographical Information Systems. So GIS specialists manage, analyze, and model geographic and spatial data on the computer. So GIS programs specifically let you look at maps and then you can overlay environmental features that will be relevant to whatever you're looking at. So for example, you can add in rivers onto a map, roads or wildlife habitat polygons. It really helps analyze the spatial information when working with scientists. So GIS specialists often work in an office environment, primarily on the computer with these GIS programs, but it can also involve a little bit of field work, potentially testing out your GIS systems if you're building apps or programs. So GIS technicians make on average around $43,000 to $54,000 according to eco.ca. Avalanche forecaster. So avalanche forecasters combine mountaineering with science in order to predict avalanches and issue avalanche warnings in mountainous areas or areas that have a risk of an avalanche. So they use their skills to determine mountain conditions, weather, snowpacks, and snow science in general to evaluate the risk of avalanches. So they work for a big variety of different places. They could work for ski hills. For example, a ski hill needs to know the avalanche risk when doing avalanche control to keep the skiers safe. Federal and local governments, such as Avalanche Canada up here in Canada. Colleges, transportation agencies, you know, if there's an avalanche affecting a potential highway, you need to have avalanche scientists looking out and detecting the risk of avalanche through this road area. And ecotourism and adventure companies. So the average salary for avalanche scientists is around $44,000. Geologist. So geologists study the physical attributes of the earth, and that's primarily rocks and minerals. They use math, physics, and technical geological knowledge in order to do their job. They often work in exploration for oil and gas, mining. So the day-to-day work for geologists involves conducting geological surveys and field studies, also drilling programs and soil and sediment sampling. The American Association of Petroleum Geologists has put the average starting salary for a geologist with a bachelor's degree of $92,000, which is quite a bit, and that raises all the way up to around $160,000 with 10 to 15 years of experience. Keep in mind also a lot of these jobs are working directly with energy companies, so that's why the salaries are a little bit higher paid. Park ranger. So park rangers implement natural resource management techniques to help deal with the day-to-day happenings in a park. This includes public safety, law enforcement programs, assisting scientists with research, monitoring wildlife, capturing and relocating problem animals, and making public presentations to the people coming through this nature area, and providing first aid and search and rescue support. So this one is almost completely in the field, often in remote areas, we'll maybe go out for a whole season. And it also includes maybe a little bit of office work as well to deal with the administrative side. So park rangers on average make around $52,000 a year. I will say just because you have a bachelor's degree doesn't mean you're guaranteed to get any of these jobs. You still have to incorporate internships, you have to incorporate volunteer work, skills outside of school in order to get into one of these fields. If you want to hear more about how actually to get an internship that's going to help you get a job, check out my internship video I will link to above, and that one goes through why internships are important, how to get an internship, and what you need to do to build your resume to get a job after you graduate. If you guys want to hear even more environmental career ideas, leave a comment below, ask for a part 3, I might do one depending on how many people are interested. There still is some more jobs that I haven't covered in these 2 videos. Let me know which of these jobs or the jobs in my other video do you find the most interesting and maybe you want to pursue. So leave a comment below and let me know. And thank you for watching.